famous for that.
Welcome to Running the Kitchen. I'm Johnny Vaccaro. Today I'm going to be making one of my favorite dishes, spicy turkey chili. This dish is going to be perfect for athletes. Think about the last time you got back from your long run. It's a nice cold winter's day. What do you crave most? Probably something warm, right? Well, turkey chili is the way to go. It not only packs a bunch of protein from your turkey and your beans, but it's also nice and warm to help you recover. Plenty of antioxidants in our tomatoes, and our spices are sure to rev you up so that you're ready for your next race or workout. Our list of ingredients are fairly simple.
We're going to be using about 3 pounds of ground turkey, 2 cans of both red kidney beans and whole kernel corn, 2 small cans of tomato paste, some minced garlic, about 2 cloves, some minced ginger, about 1 tablespoon, and a variety of spices, including paprika, cumin, cayenne pepper, and chili powder. We are also going to be using jarred tomato sauce. However, this is not your ordinary jarred tomato sauce. This is Mama Vaccaro's homemade tomato sauce.
My family stocks up on our sauce. We probably make about 400 bottles of sauce every summer. We're Italian, what could I say? So that's what our recipe is going to include. You're going to absolutely love it. It's gonna really spice you up. Let's get cooking. I'm ready to begin my chili. And like all my other recipes, I've already added in some of our Torchano Tuscan olive oil to our pot. It's all ready and heated up, so I'm going to go ahead and add some garlic and fresh ginger to the pot.
We're going to let our garlic and our ginger just simmer for a little bit, but we want to be careful that it doesn't brown.
It's now time to add our ground turkey.
I'm using 99% fat-free ground turkey, and I don't want to cook it all the way through right now. I just want it to brown slightly before I add my spice mixture and Mama V's famous sauce.
Our turkey is starting to brown, so I'm just gonna go ahead and add some of our spice mixture. For a base of the spice mixture, I use McCormick's spicy mixture. Just about 1 packet of that, and then later on when I add my sauce, I could really go ahead and put in some of my own spices, depending on how spicy I want it. So the turkey is browning with the spices, and the smells are unreal. It's now time to add in our sauce. I'm going to use 2 jars of sauce, Mama V's specialty sauce. And it's really going to take a good hour and a half for this chili to be ready. However, the prep time is so simple.
Like I said, the spices are really gonna kick things up a notch. So get ready, because in about 1 hour, this is going to be one of the best winter recipes that you have tried so far. Now it's time for the 2nd jar of sauce. The smells coming from this pot are unreal. And I'm going to go ahead and give that a stir. And add my tomato paste, which is really going to make this nice and thick. The consistency of a chili is really dependent on what you like. Some people like chunks of tomato, So in that situation, I would say use peeled tomatoes. Some people don't like that, so that's why I opted to use the sauce. I really think that to get a nice hearty chili, you do need to have some sort of thick consistency. Otherwise, it will just be too soupy.
So good. I didn't know anyone was watching, but what? You didn't expect me to try my own chili? Before I add the last two ingredients, which are the corn and the red kidney beans, let me go ahead and share with you some more of my top five favorite running songs to keep you motivated throughout your next workouts. You're gonna love them. Rock on. The chili is nice and thick, and the smells are so fragrant and powerful. I'm very excited to try this chili. Before I do so, I'm going to add our last ingredients, which are the beans and the corn. The beans and the corn are going to thicken up our chili even more so. I'm going to give that a good stir so that the ingredients are well incorporated into the chili. Oh, this is awesome. The color that the corn and the red beans add is also really cool. And lastly, I'm going to add some ground cumin to the mix. And give that a final stir. I covered the chili and I'm gonna let it simmer for 20 to 30 minutes on a low to medium grade heat. I'm gonna stir the chili every couple minutes and I'm gonna taste it every couple of minutes just to see if I need to add any spices to kick things up a couple notches. Don't ever worry about making too much chili. It'll last in the refrigerator for 2 to 3 days after you cook it. You could always freeze it and reheat it for the next time you're craving it. Or just call your friends over. They'll have no problem finishing it off for you. While the chili was on the stove, I took some whole wheat pitas and toasted them up so we could serve them with our chili.
Look at this nice and thick consistency. This is going to really satisfy you on a cold day. Perfect, just like that. And then we can serve it with our toasted pita.
Now it's time for the best part, to try the chili. Wow. The flavor. Those spices really pack a punch. I hope you could handle the heat. I think the pita chips are a great idea too. You could almost use them as a little dip for your chili. This is great chili. Perfect for an athlete after a cold winter's workout, or if you're just sitting at home and entertaining some friends. I hope you enjoyed this recipe as much as I did. My name is John Vaccaro, and I'll catch you guys next time on Running the Kitchen. Take care.
Remember the weight of the world, it's a sound that we used to buy on cassette.